this for me is where the magic is really on display. This is a long gallery showcasing Horatio Pagani's work from his very first car, which is a racing car right at the very end there, all the way down to some of his very latest cars. The reason I've stopped here is because this is my favorite Pagani of all time, the Zonda Cinque Roadster. They only made 5 of these. And for me, one of the most iconic design features of the car is the air intake right over the center of the car. Now imagine, this is a naturally aspirated, high revving V12 engine. You take the roof off, sure, you can hear that noise even more, but then to have it further amplified by having the induction sound right on top and between both the driver and passenger's ears is absolutely dream world scenario. Just look at the sculpture. I know I say sculpture quite a lot when I'm talking about supercars, but there really is no other word for that. It is a pure work of art. So one other thing, which is very unique about this car, is a unique substance to Pagani called carbotanium. Now, if you look really closely, you can see that there has been a titanium weave entwined within carbon fiber. So by comparison, this is what standard carbon fiber looks like. And this is carbotanium. And there are literally strands of carbon fiber mixed with sinuous, beautiful titanium strands. It's unbelievable. I often say one of the things that constitutes a hypercar is often the elements that you don't see. So for example, something that is hard to convey on camera, obviously, is just how lightweight the components are. To move this is, it's just completely, it's like pushing thick air. It's so light. And yet at the same time, it has all of this incredible sculpture and an amazing sound system, which carries on through behind the driver's headrests. And look at the housing. Check that out. That's carbon fiber housing. This is the back of this speaker. And that continues through onto passenger side and obviously throughout the rest of the car. And to sit in these things, look at the instrument cluster. It's this amazing marriage of digital and analog and insane craftsmanship. I mean, just look at the buttons to trip your drive and mileage. Whole thing's incredible. It's a sense of occasion just seeing one standing still. This is another reason why this place is very special. The car behind us, yes, it is a Zonda, but it's very special. It's a significant car because this is the development car that resulted in every iteration of Zonda since it was created. As a result, it has racked up over 500,000 kilometers of development time, and they've appropriately named it La Nona, which is grandma in Italian. I mean, look at it. I wouldn't go so far as saying that it's a Frankenstein piece because it looks so beautiful, but I say that because it has components from various different cars. So if you look there, it's got the roof scoop that eventually made it to the Cinque. The engine is more of a variation from the Zonda R. And it also has the tricolore stripe on the front of it. Very, very special piece of kit. Honored to see it. I remember reading about this car when it had around about 250,000 kilometers on it, thinking that was incredible. 500,000? Such an amazing place to be. Earlier on, I was talking about being in the inner sanctum, but we are really on the inner sanctum right now. This is the heart of the very new Pagani factory. Factory is kind of a disservice. It's more of an assembly line. Every one of these is hand-built by the Pagani team. Average build time's around about 4 months. There was a time when Pagani's had a 2-year waiting list. They brought that down a bit now due to efficiencies. But just standing here is magic. What is interesting is this whole area is replicated to represent a more traditional Italian square. So you've got things up here like the clock tower and even traditional street lamps within the factory. And it's such a tranquil, peaceful environment. And these are Huayra Roadsters. Incredibly rare. There's 3 on the production line right now. It's just I'm just in awe everywhere I look. And because I've noticed how much detail and attention to detail there is in every inch of this place, I look at everything differently. You know, earlier on I was showing you the spotlights, for example, and just that little screw housing for the display cabinet. If there's that much detail in small things like that, imagine what goes into the cars.
Customized detail, which are going to be installed into each car. Mm. So every car has its own carriage, all customized, anodized.
I mean, look at the cluster unit for the gear shifter. So this sits in the car as an exposed gear shifter unit. It's everything. You were right, you just quite rightly referred to this as almost a jewelry cabinet, and it really is like that. It's, look at the details of all of these things. This is the central housing for the steering wheel, and once again, carved from a single piece of aluminium and then anodized, and that, I'm just gonna place that gently here, that goes for every single component, and these are all of the options which have been selected by the customer, finished how they want it to be finished, and it's gonna be going into their very own car, which is being built over 4 months right here. Now, I'm not sure if you guys followed the journey when I did fly the Zonda from Dubai back here, right here, for its service. I took you around a kind of a similar tour, but it was more in depth. I mean, in a minute, I've got to go and jump on a plane to Japan, so I don't have too much time. But this was one of my favorite details on the Pagani. Earlier on, I was saying hypercars, it's often the details that you don't see that constitute why a hypercar is next level. Check out the detail on the springs on the dampers here. So Pagani, rather than sticking just standard black springs on, they have actually gone to the degree of spraying the springs themselves with a metallic fleck. It's an incredible detail that only a few people would see, because you have to have the whole clamshell here exposed to actually see it. But this is the detail that an owner would appreciate. I'm also aware that Pagani actually offer a service where the owner who's commissioned the car can come and see their car being built at stages like this and really appreciate the next level detail that goes into them. It's really, really special and such a wonderful personal experience for the customer. I wish I was one of those people.
The light, you can feel, they all have the Pagani logo on top.
So am I right in thinking that every bolt that goes in has a Pagani logo on it? Every single bolt?
Every single one.
That's incredible. Wow.
Okay, it looks like lunch break is finished for the Pagani employees. We are now going to vacate their production area and leave them to create wonderful masterpieces that will soon grace our asphalt. Pagani, thank you so much for having us. We now need to go to Japan. Ciao.